Okay, sorry about that.
I'm very good at the DJ job.
We're not nervous, right?
Not at all.
How many phones were there?
When the sun had left and the winter came and the sky fall to only bring the rain, I sat in darkness, all broken hearted. I couldn't find a day, I didn't feel alone. I never meant to cry, started losing hope. But somehow, baby, you broke through and saved me. You're an angel, tell me you never leave it.
Nick, Deanna, and also Josiah. We're gathered here for this special occasion to unite you both in marriage. Nick, as your grandfather, you are not only accepting Dana, but Josiah.
Danae,
excuse me. You're not only going to accept Danae, but you're going to also accept Josiah, a time that is going to require you both a tremendous amount of love. I'm going to read to you, but before we even read, I'm going to pray that the Lord will be with us. Our Father, I thank you for Nick and Danae and Josiah. Lord, they're a family already that is beginning to live in such a way that they're going to magnify your name. And I pray that you would give them wisdom, you'll give them understanding, and you'll be with us all as we gathered here this morning. Just bless, Father, I pray, in your wonderful name. Amen. I'm going to read to you a letter that Nick sent to Josiah. Quite often, marriage is viewed as the union of two people, but marriage is more than that. And this morning we witnessed not only the joining of two people, but the creation of an extended family. Dana's son, Josiah. Danae's son, Josiah. You're gonna have to forgive me right off the bat. Danae's son, Josiah, is a big part of who she has become and will continue to play a very intricate role in this family. As Nick becomes Danae's husband, his life will be touched by Josiah, much like a canvas is touched by the brush of a stroke of an artist. The magnificent mural of our lives is made up of our relationship with others. Josiah, your mom wants you to know that the promises she makes this morning, as she and Nick marry, are also promises to you, to bind you with a loving family environment where you will always feel loved and welcome. And Nick wants to promise to always be there for you when you need someone, whether it be a coach, a dad, a friend, anything you need, Josiah, anything you need. Now listen, anything you need, whether it be a coach, a dad, a friend, you can always come to Nick, and he will be your shoulder, and he thanks you for sharing your mommy with him and welcoming him into your family. You both are entering a time that is going to require you and Danae to make sure that you both abide in the loving arms of the Lord, so you both bear good fruit within your lives, as well as Josiah and all you meet in life. I'm going to read how God set up marriage in the beginning of human history from Genesis 2, beginning with the 18th verse. And the Lord God said, "It is not good that man be alone. I will make him a helper comparable to him." Out of the ground, the Lord God formed every beast of the field, every bird of the air, and brought them to Adam to see what he would call them. And whatever Adam called each living creature, that was its name. So Adam gave names to all cattle, to the birds of the air, and to every beast of the field. But for Adam, there was not found a helper comparable to him. And the Lord God caused a great sleep to fall on Adam. So Adam fell asleep. No. And he slept. And he took one of his ribs and closed up the flesh in its place. Then the rib, which God made, was made into a woman. He made it into a woman. And he brought her to the man. And Adam said, "This is now bone of my bones, flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman," because she was taken out of a man. "Therefore, a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." Nick, thank the Lord for the fact you get to cleave to Deanna.
Danae.
Why, Nick? Am I making so many mistakes here? I'm nervous. I guess I must be. Danae, you're becoming one. You're leaving the past behind, and you're accepting the present. I challenge you to live every day of your lives as one from this day forward, keeping Christ at the center of your marriage as well as in your individual lives. Doing that will result in successful marriage. Nicholas Campfield? And Danae Buell? At this time, I would like you to pledge to yourselves and all here present, including Josiah, your vows to one another. Nick, please take Danae's hands in yours and repeat these vows after me. I, Nicholas Campfield.
I, Nicholas Campfield.
Take you, Danae Buell.
Take you, Danae Buell.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
Along with Josiah.
Along with Josiah.
As my son.
As my son.
I will have you.
I will have you.
And to hold you.
And to hold you.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better.
Or worse.
Or worse.
For richer.
For richer.
Or poor.
Or poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
And please take Nick's hands in yours and repeat these vows after me. I like it. I, Danae Buell.
I, Danae Buell.
Take you, Nicholas Campfield.
Thank you, Nicholas Campfield.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
I will to have you.
I vow to have you.
And hold you.
Hold you.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or poor.
For richer or for poor.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness
and in health. To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted.
Until we are parted.
By death.
By death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Nick, what token of praise or are you going to give to Danae Buell for your love?
Thank you.
A ring. Do you have that ring? Nick, please place this ring on Danae's finger and repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And herewith I give.
And herewith I give.
Thee my love.
Thee my love.
And devotion.
And devotion.
So long as we both shall live.
So long as we both shall live.
Danae, what token you give to Nicholas?
A ring.
With this ring I thee wed.
This ring I thee wed. And herewith
I give thee my love.
I give thee my love.
And devotion.
And devotion.
So long as we both shall live.
So long as we both shall live.
At this time, we're going to have communion. At the final Passover, Jesus shared with the disciples. He got up from the meal to wash his disciples' feet. He took bread and breaking it gave to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body." Then he took the cup and offered it to his disciples, saying, "This is the blood of the New Testament, which is shed for many." At this time, we'd like the family to come forward. I might say this, communion is probably one of the most precious times that we are able to enjoy as Christians. There's always a warning to communion. And so do not feel bad if you cannot take communion. Communion is for those that love the Lord. Those that have accepted the Lord as their personal Savior. And if we take communion and we're not worthy, God says that there's going to be some repercussions. And that's where we have many people in our world today that are weak and sickly among us. So I would challenge you, when you take this communion, if you've never accepted the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, do this. Ask the Lord to come in and then make sure that you ask Him to forgive you of your sin. And when you ask the Lord to forgive us of our sin, guess what? We're clean, we're pure, we're righteous. And so you have that opportunity to take communion. So blessings to you as you partake of this communion. And I think the family's gonna have something to say here.
Individuals.
and this moment flesh. I thank you, Father, that you have made provision.
I see you're holding your communion in your hand. And we're going to pray for the body, that body will become a part of us. So, Lord, I thank you for the wafer, the bread, the body that everyone has in their hand. I thank you that your body was bruised, it was broken, that we do not have to be broken and bruised, but that, Lord, we can have forgiveness and we can have healing in our body. And so, Lord, be with us now as we partake of your body. I pray this in your name. Amen. So let's take of the wafer, if you all have it. We'll wait. Nick was just telling me that they forgot the bread, so we're sorry. I didn't understand. But we do have the wine in your cup that represents the blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. And you know, may I have one too?
Yes.
I'd like to take communion with you all. There's something that's unique. This blood has never been able to be reproduced. You can get a transfusion, but never be reproduced. One of these days, you and I are going to have a new body and new blood. It's never going to be impure. It's always going to be pure. And I can't imagine what heaven is going to be like. But we're going to be together forever and ever. So let's pray. Our Father, I thank you for this blood. We don't even like to talk about blood. But Lord, it was your blood that was spilled upon this world that everyone could have life and that they could have it eternally. And so, Lord, be with us now as we partake of this blood, I pray, in your wonderful name. Amen. Let's take together. Now at this time, we have a unity glass. Josiah. And Josiah, is he here? Yeah, he's gonna get to be a part of this.
Let's go to your glass.
Come here, the glass.
Come here, your glass. Let's go do it.
What? Come here. Do you remember your glass?
Come here, let's go to your glass. Yeah. Come here.
I'm okay.
You can bring it with you.
That's good. That's good. That's good, Josiah. That's good. Yeah.
Come on, do the glass. You want the green one?
Dana and Nick, Josiah, have chosen colors of glass.
This is yours.
That represents each of them in a special and unique way.
Okay.
Throughout their lives, they have been colorful. Complete, amazing people, all on their own. Just like the glass. But today is special. Today, they become a family and create a new, beautiful combination of their colors. Nick and Danae, Josiah, are together creating a new life and mixing their personalities and characteristics in their marriage. Symbolic, they are creating something unique to just the three of them in their wedding vows and marriage. After their unity glass ceremony today, the colorful mixed pieces of glass will be made into one-of-a-kind glass sculpture as special as their love for each other. The pieces of their personality that complement each other will be reflected in the glass sculpture that they can display in their home forever. The new sculpture will be a physical reminder of their beautiful personality, love, and commitment to each other coming together. Now is the moment that you have been waiting for. And that is, Nick, you get to kiss your bride.
Ready?
It is my absolute pleasure to present to you for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Nicholas Campfield.
I turned it off. Just think about Shut Up and Dance. Watch what they're doing for you. Oh. What'd you think?
Brian.
A little bit of a costume. A little bit of a costume.
There we go.
Turn the speaker off.
Thank you.